Malaria is one of the biggest killers of people in the world, and especially in children under the age of 5 in Africa. And it's been particularly hard to target with a vaccine. What we've found is a fantastic candidate that may be the Achilles heel, the key weakness that allows us to develop a truly effective vaccine.
So malaria is caused by a parasite, the most virulent of which is Plasmodium falciparum. Most people, in terms of the treatment of the disease, have focused on the blood stages of the infection because the blood stage of the parasite is actually exposed, albeit very briefly, to the immune system of the host.
So invasion of the red blood cells by Plasmodium falciparum is believed to rely on several protein-protein interactions between proteins displayed at the surface of the red blood cells and proteins present at the surface of the parasite. There were a few that had been identified in the literature and published, but none of them were thought to be absolutely critical for invasion.
For the first time, we observed that blocking one particular receptor on the surface of the red blood cell inhibited completely the entry of the parasite into red blood cells.
These protein-protein interactions are very weak and transient, so they happen very, very quickly, and it's very difficult to detect them in the laboratory. So the most exciting result was when we found that the antibody could block the interaction completely.
So the hope is that because we think we've identified an absolutely essential interaction required by the parasite to invade the red blood cell, this now really simplifies the design of vaccines. We now know that we only have to target a single interaction rather than many.
There's currently no effective vaccine against malaria. We have a range of drugs that can treat the symptoms that kill the parasite once people are infected, but we don't have an effective way to prevent infection in the first place. And vaccine development for malaria has been a long and very difficult process. Although we now have hopeful signs with the first large-scale malaria vaccine trial, there is no doubt that we'll need even more effective vaccines in the future. And that's what this finding may produce.